Christmas. It's a joyous time of the year, Christmas, when millions of people around the globe celebrate in a variety of ways. Here in America, children are visited by Santa Claus, a magical fat man from the North Pole who slides down the chimney, leaves presents under a tree. But in Australia, where I'm from, instead of Santa Claus, we were visited by the Christmas Kangaroo, who brought gifts for all the boys and girls. But the Christmas Kangaroo wouldn't just give you the gifts. See, we Australians are a rough and tumble bunch, and this kangaroo lived by a code. Your father would have to fight him for the gifts. Sometimes the fights would turn nasty. But when your dad won, you would get anything you wanted. Christmas was my favourite time of the year. I always look forward to the return of the Christmas kangaroo. But then when I was 12, tragedy struck. My dad lost the fight. When the kangaroo won, it was pretty much up to him what happened next. More times than not, that meant we didn't get presents. And my dad got sodomized. It was a rough time around the Jackman homestead. I thought things would get better next Christmas, but no. My father ended up losing the next 4 years in a row. It was horrible. After a while, I questioned if my dad was even trying to win.
Dan, looks like you win. Again. Kids, go get him a scotch and soda.
I mean, sure, the kangaroo gave us gifts, but I just felt dirty accepting them. It seemed like a hell of a price to pay just so I could have a sweater vest, you know. Luckily, when I was 17, after a 5-year winning streak, the kangaroo lost.
Hello, Freckles. No! You killed Freckles! I mean, yay, it's over.
And that's how the Christmas Kangaroo's reign of terror ended. Now, sure, now on Christmas morning, all the Australian boys and girls might not get toys, but they're spared the horror of watching a giant marsupial take their old man to Browntown. And isn't that what Christmas is all about?